I've been on a hunt for new earbuds. Earbuds that have ANC, which means ambient noise canceling. While I can choose the over-the-ear Bose Quiet Comforts, the Sony WH-1000 XM3s, or the Apple AirPods Max, they're just too big to pack, especially as a frequent traveler on the go. So in this video, I'm going to tell you the reason why I chose the WF-1000 XM4s by Sony. I'm going to tell you why I think they're the best option for everyday carry bags and travelers looking for one of the best packable ANC earbuds. Welcome, I'm Chuck, and today we're talking about tech gear for travel. These are the Sony WF-1000 XM4 ambient noise canceling earbuds. Whew. That's a lot to say. So for the sake of this video, I'm just going to call them the XM4s. While I reviewed some passive noise canceling earbuds, companies like Apple and Bose have come out with active noise canceling earbuds, and so I've been mulling over them and waiting to see which ones are really worth buying. Now, while I like Apple products, I've never had luck with any of their earbuds. The wired EarPods and the AirPods 2 never stayed in my ears. One reviewer had problems with the AirPods Pro, so I didn't want to buy and have to return something that didn't fit and fall out like the other versions of the AirPods. Late 2019, Sony released the WF-1000 XM3s. Who comes up with these names over at Sony? Anyway, the XM3s were similar to my Pfizer earbuds, and while they had noise-canceling features, decent battery life, the case was big, and they weren't water resistant at all. So I continued doing my research, waiting, and even considering holding out to see what the newer version of Apple AirPods Pro would be like. Well, Sony came up with a newer version of the XM3s and released the Sony WF-1000 XM4s. So I took the plunge, and I bought them. The XM4s are about $30 more expensive than the AirPods Pro at $280. I put links to them in the description below. Now, everyone's been touting the eco-friendly packaging, and it's great because you don't need sharp scissors or a heavy knife to cut through plastic just to get to the product. And because I've had them over a week now, I waited to give you a review because most of the big reviewers who got promotional pre-release models have moved on to other products. And I want to give you my take as a consumer like you. Now, I purchased these on my own, so I'll give you the specs, what I experienced, and why I think they're great for travel and everyday use. So here's some quick tech specs of the XM4. Included in the package was a USB to USB-C charging cable. There were small and large earbud tips since the already installed earbud size is medium. Now the XM4s have a new V1 processor to improve battery life, sound, and an upgraded Bluetooth 5.4. It also has a smaller case than the XM3s, and it's a USB-C charging case which can also charge on a wireless charging pad. It's also magnetic so the earbuds don't accidentally fall out. Now the earbuds are IPX4 water resistant and have two onboard mics on each earbud. Two on the outside for honing in on the sound around you and for noise canceling and doing something they call beamforming to hone in on your voice for phone calls. There's also a sensor on the inside surface of the earbud to hear your voice using bone conduction technology, so it can automatically switch to ambient sound mode. This is so you can hear others around you when you're in a conversation. It also works for Android and iOS and has something called DSEE, which is a digital sound enhancement engine designed to upscale digital music files like AAC. Now for you sound hounds, if you have LDAC files, you can only hear them on the Android platform if your phone or tablet has an app that can support those files. So with all those specs aside, why do I like these and think they're great for travelers and for everyday life? Well, first, the case is small and it's pocketable. While I didn't have the XM3s, this case is smaller than that version, and I didn't have trouble stowing them in my flight bag or in my pocket. The case can help you charge on the go, so you can extend the use of the earbuds to 24 hours, and much like the AirPods Pro, a 5-minute quick charge of the earbuds inside the case can give you an additional 1.5 hours of listening time. Now, I also like the ear tips. They're squishy, much like the Comply ear tips that came with some of my other earbuds, and because you squeeze them and compress them before you put them in your ears, once they're in, they'll expand to fit. This creates a seal inside your ears to help filter outside noise, and it also helps others from hearing your audio in situations where they might be seated next to you on an airplane, bus, train, or even the cubicle next to you. Also, the Sony Headphones Connect app can do a similar test like the AirPods to help you find the right size ear tips. Now, another cool thing, pairing was easy. All I had to do was scan a QR code on the packaging to get the Sony Headphones Connect app for iOS. And once I did that, it was so easy to pair the headphones, I really forgot how it happened. I just followed the directions on the app and I was connected. Now, I got to test these on my flights to and from my yearly flight attendant training, so here are some other great features I experienced along the way. With regard to noise canceling, it's awesome and customizable. When you have noise canceling on, the earbuds can last for 8 hours, which is more than the AirPods Pro. They're rated at 4.5 hours in noise canceling mode. You can change from noise canceling to ambient sound mode, and this is where you can control the volume of your surroundings to hear voices and stuff around you, or you can tone it down just enough for awareness. You can also set it to focus on voices and situations where you might be conversing with someone. And this worked when the flight attendant asked me if I wanted something to drink and I didn't have to remove my earbuds. Now, the noise canceling was so good, I didn't hear a noisy aircraft duct nearby pushing a lot of air and some loud conversations on the airplane. Another feature I was impressed with was adaptive sound. I didn't realize I had it on. The earbuds were occasionally beeping as I listened to music and podcasts, and since I was in airplane mode, I knew it wasn't a phone call or notifications, so when I looked down at the Headphones Connect app, I saw the adaptive sound feature was on. In this mode, with noise canceling, the earbuds were adapting to the noise around me. It had determined I was on a plane, so it went into transport mode. It can detect when you're running, walking, or just stationary. The beeps were annoying after a while, so I discovered how to turn it off. At the bottom of the adaptive sound control page, there's a switch to turn off notification tone when switching. Another thing about adaptive sound control is when you have the app on, it can learn to adapt for noise where you are by registering your locations using your phone's GPS. Now, for battery life and privacy, you can always shut the learning off so the GPS isn't constantly polling your location as it learns. So when I worked out, the earbuds didn't fall out of my ears. I ran with them on the treadmill, and even when I was sweating, they stayed in place and they didn't have a problem with sweat. The XM4s are IPX4 rated for water resistance, which means it can resist splashes of water from any direction. And here's why that matters. A few years ago, I was in the middle of a run and I got caught in a sudden Florida rainstorm. I had a call for a rescue ride home. The earbuds didn't work after the call because they didn't recover from being exposed to water. They weren't water resistant, so they were trashed afterwards. If I had the XM4s with the IPX4 water resistance, they would have held up to the rain. Now, another feature is you can customize sound through the Sony Headphones Connect app. Now, there are 8 presets built into the app, and unlike the AirPods, the best thing I like is you can manually customize sound with a 5-band equalizer and the amount of bass with a clear bass control. You can also create your own and save 2 custom presets of your liking. Now, some reviewers had said the sound of the bass was too heavy. I didn't find that to be my experience. Because you can customize the equalizer, all I did was increase the mids and high frequencies for clarity of instruments and voices and turn down clear bass control a few steps. Now, you can't do that on the AirPods. So what didn't I like about the XM4s? Well, initially I didn't like the gold rings around the outside of the beamforming mics. I know it's probably for branding because both the black pair and the silver version, which actually looks like a white stone color, have the same gold rings. It's probably for branding because you can't exactly put WF1000 XM4 on the side of the headphones, right? Well, I would rather have seen a sleek black chrome look so they're not easily spotted, especially when you're traveling. Also, sound from the beamforming mics is okay for phone calls. Other reviewers said it's been improved over the XM3s, and to test sound, I did a phone call with my mom. She said it sounded like I was on a mobile device, but it was acceptable. It didn't sound as clear as my iPhone or my Apple Watch, but she said she could understand me. Now, I'm not really a phone person who has lengthy conversations on earbuds, but here's a sample from the mics for those of you who may use this for phone calls or video conferencing.
So this is a sound check of the WF1000 XM4s with the Busy air conditioner on behind me. You can see the fan And on the other side of my courtyard here, on the other side of the wall, is a noisy street. So how does it sound? Can you hear anything? So I just turned off noise canceling on the WF-1000XM4s. So this is what it sounds like with that noisy air conditioner, which is on, and then the busy street on the other side of the wall. How does it sound?
So it looks like the next phase for headphones and earbuds is spatial audio, or what Sony calls in their app 360-degree reality audio. While you can set it up on your XM4s, it's only supported by the streaming subscription platforms Deezer, Nugs, and Tidal. If you have those platforms, great. But for me, I don't need another subscription, so not really a feature that would apply to me. Now, what some may not like is the possibility of an earbud falling out and losing it. I've seen online posts where some have had that experience with other brands of wireless earbuds. When I was working a flight, an AirPod Pro fell into the plane aisle on takeoff and slid from the front to our galley in the back of the plane. People drop earbuds on the airplane quite a bit, and I've had to help many passengers try to find their AirPods on the floor or in between passenger seats. The XM4s seem a bit bigger than the AirPods and the AirPods Pro, so it looks like they would be easier to find, but as always, just be careful with your tech, especially when traveling. Now, before I get on to who this is for, let me know in the comments below, are you planning to get new earbuds soon? Are you waiting for the next version of the AirPods Pro? Tell me down below. So who are the XM4s for? Well, if you're like me and want a small, easy to carry pair of earbuds that sound great and have some of the best noise canceling features, these just may be for you. The IPX4 water resistance with the ability to hear ambient sounds around you also makes this a great pair of earbuds for working out and training outside. If you like customizing your sound, the ability to hear your surroundings, and enough power to last throughout your entire day, this is also a great pair to consider. So, was it worth waiting for and finally purchasing the XM4s? I think so. All those features make the Sony WF-1000 the best earbuds for me as a traveler. So do me a favor, smash that like button if you found value in this video. And here's something I like, Atomic Habits. My reward for finishing this video is waiting for me in the kitchen. Peanut M&Ms. In the meantime, leave me a comment below. Find me on Instagram or Facebook at Tech Travel Beyond, and check out these other videos. Thanks for watching.